Good morning, you all. Let's continue with the discussion of ASEAN. And in my previous lecture, I had explained to you this thing that the basic objective of ASEAN is totally an economic one, and that is to provide stability and peace in the region, that is South Asia. And ASEAN is one of the fastest growing economies in the world, especially in Asia. And the way European Union, no doubt, so far the aspirations of becoming a supranational organization is considered, ASEAN is not one of them. Of course, ASEAN cannot be compared in this regard. ASEAN cannot be compared with the European Union, so far that kind of a power is concerned. But even then, ASEAN is one of the fastest growing economies in the world, and it's speed of its economy which makes it a very attractive proposition for all the strong players on international platform. In this regard only, now ASEAN has gone a little bit ahead, and then that is the reason ASEAN has now three pillars, three dimensions, that is ASEAN Security Community, ASEAN Economic Community, and ASEAN Socio-Cultural Community. First of all, let's go for this ASEAN Security Community. As the name implies, the basic objective of ASEAN Security Community is whatever disputes have been over there amongst the countries of the South Asian whatever confrontations are over there, whatever conflicts are over there, they will always be sorted out in a peaceful manner, only and only through dialogues. There will be no use of weapons, there will be no war, and that is the basic objective of ASEAN Security Community. And no doubt they have been quite successful in getting this objective, because after the formation of this ASEAN Security Community, not a single direct confrontation is over there which ever took place between any of the members of ASEAN formation. The ASEAN Regional Forum, that is ARF, it was established in 1994, is the organization that carries out coordination and security and foreign policy. That is the forum which works for a common foreign policy of these ASEAN member states. That is the forum over which the member states of all this ASEAN formation, the member states can sit together and they can talk over any kind of dispute which can take place. And this is the basic objective of ASEAN Security Community. I repeat, respecting the sovereignty, the independence of all the member states. Whatever disputes, whatever conflicts will be over there amongst any of the member states of like ASEAN members, it will always be sorted out only and only through dialogues, only and only through talks. Any kind of war, any kind of use of weapon will always be avoided. Now let's talk about ASEAN Economic Community. In the beginning only, I had already explained it, we know it very well, that the basic objective of the formation of ASEAN was totally economic one. It was just to give a trigger to the economic growth of these member states that this ASEAN came into being. But now it is turning into a very powerful economic organization. Even then, if we compare its power, it is quite small. If we compare it with the economy of Japan, US or European Union, but the speed with which it is growing, again I am repeating it, the speed of its economic growth makes it a very interesting proposition to all the strong players in international politics, may it be the US, may it be China or even India. That is the reason, as an economic community, ASEAN is getting a very powerful forum. This accounts for the growth in its influence both in the region and beyond. And the basic objective of ASEAN Economic Community are to create a common market and to create a common production base for within ASEAN states only. The basic objective of ASEAN Economic Community is to create a common market and to create a common production base for the member states of ASEAN, to create a free trade area for the movement of labor, for the movement of capital, for the movement of technology, for the movement of consumers and customers, I must say, amongst the member states of ASEAN. And this free trade area has been so beneficial for the economic growth of the member states that even America and China, they have signed this free trade FTA with ASEAN states. ASEAN is rapidly growing into a very important regional organization. Its Vision 2020 has defined an outward-looking role for ASEAN in the international community. ASEAN is turning great respect on international platform when we talk about its strength in solving the disputes in a peaceful manner, in a help to help each other economically, or to give a common market, to provide a common production base to its member states. It is turning into a very powerful organization, and this is the basic strength of ASEAN. When we talk about India's outlook towards ASEAN, initially at the time of Cold War, India did not pay much attention to ASEAN. But when we declared ourselves to be an open market and we observed the speed with which the ASEAN economy is growing, now India is paying a great attention to ASEAN. And in recent years, India has tried to make amends. It signed FTA with two ASEAN members, Singapore and Thailand, and we are trying to sign an FTA with ASEAN itself. ASEAN's strength, however, lies in its policies of interaction and consultation with member state. That is, again and again throughout my lectures, I have been harping upon just one statement, that the basic strength of ASEAN, it lies only and only in solving out any of the disputes only and only in a highly informal manner and in a very peaceful manner, only and only through dialogues. And that is a basic objective of ASEAN socio-cultural community also, which works for cultural exchange programs, which works for peace, which works for dialogues amongst the countries of these ASEAN, for the member states of ASEAN forum. ASEAN countries and the major powers can discuss political and security concerns, and that is the basic power of ASEAN. That now ASEAN is becoming into a turning into a very attractive proposition for the basic power, for all the powerful states of the world, and they are keeping a very keen eye at the economic growth, at the socio-cultural peace, and the way this ASEAN has been trying, the way ASEAN has been successful, I must say, in settling their disputes, because they have been successful in settling this Cambodian conflict and Timor crisis. So I must say that ASEAN is one of the most important alternative centers of power in near future. Thank you.